Welcome back.
Let's go find Shawnee.
Let's go find a house.
Yeah, we're going to go get him a house, and we're going to go party with his dead brother.
I think we should do the party first. I like that idea.
I don't know.
And we're going to ride all the way there, because I'm going to still talk about this stupid fucking show.
This show, where did the show touch you, Mason?
I'll get to that in a minute.
This show. Oh, okay. We're not there yet.
Her ass gets grabbed in the police station, or not the police station, the fucking show.
Whoa there, Roach.
It'll be a ride, dude.
Bit of a ride. It's fine. Figure it out.
You wanted 10 parts? Fuck you, I'm making it 12.
Yeah, exactly.
I planned all week last week to talk about this. You don't understand.
Yeah, let's do it.
Like, since me and the lady decided, fuck this show, we're just going to look up what happens in the show. From that moment on, I was like, I'm talking about this.
Let's do it.
So, at this point, she's been groped, sent pictures saying that she is... Or, like, showing her a picture and then told us, like, about her panties and shit. And then people say she's easy. And then she gets a picture sent around of her kissing another girl. And then that girl says that it's her in the picture and not... Or says that it's the girl that killed herself. I think her name's Hannah in the show. So the girl that kills herself, Hannah. She says it's Hannah, not the Asian girl. And she says that she didn't want it to come out that it was her because her parents, the gay dads...
Don't like gay people.
No, this is where I got severely confused. She's like, it comes out that her parents are gay, and then the whole entire episode, you're like, what does it matter if you're a lesbian? In their eyes, you're just like them.
Yeah,
and it comes out
should be like fucking happy if anything. Like, yeah, celebrating.
She doesn't want, because her gay parents have already gone through the entire situation,
right,
of being gay throughout their lives, and their adopted child, if she is also gay, how does that look at their look for them, you know what I mean? Where it's like, oh, you guys were gay, so you made this adopted kid gay. I think is where she's going with it. She never, like, expands on the entire situation.
Right.
So it's kind of like, she hasn't expanded yet, I should say.
Mm-hmm.
And, so she, like, has a breakdown thing that happens at that point. And so earlier you might have remembered all of these people get these tapes.
Yeah.
And so not only have they gotten these tapes and all listened to them, they have not taken these tapes to the family.
Explaining what she's gonna do.
Yeah, her explaining the whole situation of her killing herself and like why this is all.
So how did the high school kids get the tapes over before her parents did?
Because she sent them in the mail before she did it, and she also gave it to another kid in the high school.
Yeah.
Who has copies of the tapes? And so, the parents have not gotten them, and like at one point. In the chronological tape episodes.
Right.
The main character is sitting in a room with Hannah's mom. And her mom's like crying and she's like, do you know anything about her? Like, did she ever talk to you about bullying or anything? Because her parents now have a lawsuit against the school.
Right.
To try and stop bullying, like saying that like the school should have done something about it.
As they all do.
Yeah. And so she's like asking him like, hey, do you, like, know anything? Do you have anything to say about this? You know, like, did you ever talk to her very much? Were you her friend and stuff? And he's just like, I should go. And, like, he has the tapes in his hoodie pocket.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, he doesn't say anything because he just leaves. Like...
It's kind of fucked up.
Yeah. This grieving mother.
Yeah. But fuck her. I mean, who gives a shit about her? Right?
Yeah, and like that's kind of like what happens in the show, and it's just like, that's another thing that's kind of like taking me away from it. It's like, you've had so many chances,
yeah,
to just give this to her, and like, and the reason why they don't, essentially, is they're like, it's not what Hannah wanted.
Show me what you have.
She wanted us all to listen to these tapes. And I'm just like, what are you talking about?
She didn't want her parents to have the tapes. Like, what, isn't that who she would have recorded the tapes for?
Exactly. And it's the whole entire show is about these tapes telling people why she killed herself and that it's their fault, not hers.
No, it's her fault.
So
she can go fuck herself.
Exactly. And like, that's another thing that's kind of bothered me. And like,
yeah, go ahead and blame whoever the hell you want. Like, you didn't get help from anybody. Fuck you. It's your fault.
Yeah.
People are assholes. People are assholes to a lot of people. Not everyone's running around killing themselves because of it.
Yes.
I've tested the slime samples.
Oh. Hey, she
I
looks a lot better
I'll
now.
I'll be able to brew an antidote.
Cleaned up.
Mm-hmm.
Good. A poxin and army can prove more ravaging.
I swear I've seen this face before.
Your service will be recognized.
Oh, really?
How?
Kitty's freaking out.
Will I get a toad-shaped medal?
I think she's scratching.
Ambies don't got any medal like that.
Geralt? Are you all right? What's that on your face?
Long story.
Which one?
Yeah. I think business. They're used to seeing the normal
you
ones.
Catch up later.
Yes.
Oh, her right. Necklace looks way cooler without the goop.
I'll get
over.
To work on the antidote. Shouldn't take long.
Hey, I thought it was like a bow. But now it just looks like the medical symbol.
I never noticed it before.
Tasty number, that medic. Not like a scholar at all.
Ooh. scholars aren't look like? Necessarily ugly,
interesting.
Right?
Interesting. Curious to know. What do scholars look like to your mind?
Well, all that reading's hard on the eyes, right? So they wear spectacles.
Oh, aye. Thick ones, propped on wrinkled noses, and their clothing... frumpy at best. Who've they got to dress up for? The books?
Fascinating, really. But if I were you, I'd make sure no medic ever overhears you.
Huh? Why's that?
Because when you get cut in a battle, she might just refuse to stitch you back up.
You're a lucky bastard, witch. We've seen her making eyes at you. Not like she looks at us. Isn't that right? Admit it. You fancy her too, eh?
Now, here's the thing, before you answer. This is before the final area of the game, because we've technically traveled back in time to play, because we already got the ending where it shows the future. And it's like, yeah, Geralt and Yennefer run off and everything. So...
can we ruin that?
We can't, because we already got it. It's on video. I have pictures.
I have proof.
I have moving pictures.
Well, she is a beautiful woman. I guess is what you're telling me.
Well, I'm just saying
all the words you're bouncing off my head.
No, before your answer, it's just a thought, and it's a process where it's like, okay, well, what we do now doesn't matter because we already have the ending. So this is just us going back in time doing what we want. So,
right. So this is like an alternate universe, Geralt.
Yes,
is what you're saying. So I think she's a beautiful woman.
It's if we want to try and bang her, it's okay. Now we already have Yennefer. We live long lives.
This is alternate universe Geralt that doesn't care as much
this
about Yennefer.
This witcher died in his bed in the other universe. He doesn't have to die in his bed. He can die in her bed. When Yennefer finds out.
A blind man to shrug and turn away.
Too true. Meantime, you witches have got especially sharp senses.
We can hear her hair growing and see through her clothes.
Here's the medicine.
Mm-hmm.
It's a strong solution, so careful with the dosage. Each patient gets exactly
and apparently
two
we've
drops
got a thing for redheads.
3 times a day.
Dude, I love
at
redheads.
Most, in 3-4 days, the infection should recede.
Yeah.
They're,
We talked about this forever ago, back when we were dealing with Triss.
That's true. I think Geralt likes redheads, too. Or Geralt likes everyone.
Mm-hmm. Well, our Geralt does.
Black hair, blonde hair. We killed blonde hairs.
Yeah,
I mean,
we killed that one.
Doesn't mean we didn't do her.
Yeah. I'd help we definitely fucked her.
Well, were I in a position to. Kedwenis, Edirnian, elves, dwarves, halflings, the same. Come on, Geralt. You know me.
Do I know you? Where you been these past years?
Aside from the incident in the sewers, we last saw each other. Must have been in Vizima.
Yes. Yes. When it was ravaged by the Catriona.
Feels like a century ago. Where have you been? What have you been doing since?
Well, I left Vizima and returned to Oxenfurt, proceeded to finish my doctorate, and then opened a practice.
And you also opened your
shortly
shirt.
Shortly thereafter, mm-hmm. War broke out, and I was press-ganged into the Redanian Medical Corps.
That sounds very sexual.
Yeah, classic.
Want to reword that, lady?
can't complain, really.
You are a doctor, after
I've
all.
I've lived at home since the fighting subsided, resumed my practice, and simply treat the ill. Though I must always be ready, for at any time the Redanians might knock with some painfully urgent assignment.
Now, before you go any further, did you hear about the doctor and the United Airlines thing?
Yeah, it's pretty fucked up.
Yeah, I know. Doctors shouldn't act like that, dude.
I know. I like... Is the way he was screaming was pretty funny, though.
I didn't watch the video. I just think it's stupid that the doctor acted like that. But I don't want to get into that on this one, or on this episode, or video, or series, or anything, because... God, that shit enrages me.
What?
The doctor, not the United Airlines. They didn't do the right thing, and, like, you know, they tore him out and everything, but...
But him, like, refusing to get off?
Him being a child, because... First off, he has a cancer patient. I understand that.
Right.
Are they terminal or not? Because if they're terminal, okay. What are you doing? They're terminal. Nothing.
But still.
Or if they're not terminal, they have another day.
Mm-hmm.
Like, things will be fine.
I just wouldn't want to get off regardless.
I'm aware.
Fuck that shit. Need your help.
Shani, I need your help this time.
Oh.
I'd guess this wasn't a social call. All right. Tell me what you need. Is it at all related to that mark on your face?
Very.
And you must tell me what happened in the sewers.
I killed a prince and was taken prisoner.
Where do I start? All right. Monster in the sewers turned out to be a giant toad. And this toad was actually a prince. And Ophiri wanted that.
And I'm a Kaviri Duchess.
It's the truth, uncolored, I swear. When I killed the toad, some Ophiri soldiers led by a maid showed up, captured me. Man named Gontaro Dim freed me.
Who's this?
Someone powerful? I don't really know.
Honestly, I don't really know. I would just,
I don't
frankly,
really know.
I don't really know. He helped me out of a bind. Now he expects me to fulfill some nobleman's wishes in return. First one's to summon the ghost of his brother, then show him the time of his life.
Amuse a ghost? How do you intend to do that?
Not my chief concern at the moment. Gotta find his grave and summon him first, then we'll see.
But that's necromancy. It's extraordinarily risky and involves higher magic.
Odim told me how to do it. No sorceress or necromancy involved. Gave me this concoction that summons ghosts. I'll need a censer, too.
Well, that can be arranged. They keep one in a storehouse at the academy. I can fetch it for you.
Thanks.
Don't mention it. But I still don't like this.
Don't want.
Neither do I. But
I like
any
it, though.
Options. Gotta summon that ghost.
I understand. Whose ghost is it?
Olgierd von Everek's brother.
Von Everek? In my third year at Oxenfurt, we had to choose an elective. My options were Pearls of Wisdom from the Hierarchs, or Famous Redanian Dynasties.
She chose Dynasties.
I chose the latter.
Told you.
Here
surprise, surprise.
How else could she have ever helped us?
I know.
Von Igrid, von... Estakin... Von Everek! It says Olgierd had a brother named Vladimir. He lies in the family crypt near their manor.
Thanks. Knew I could count on you. I'm off.
Is their manor...
The crypt is described as quite a work of art.
I hope not.
I'd love to see it.
Probably not.
Why don't I bring the censer? We can meet at the entrance.
Before or after we fuck? Because I don't want you dead.
Maybe after. She's not blonde, so we won't kill her.
No, I guess you're right.
Not gonna be a problem. All right, well, let's go to the family crypt. All right, back to your story. Oh.
So.
Wait, how far is it?
It's all the way back to the house.
God damn it. Well, let's walk back.
Where's the brother? I don't know. Ask Shawnee. You mean turn left?
Yeah.
Back, like, 2 feet ago?
Mm-hmm. Well, he's not gonna help us.
Yeah, but still.
Because he thinks we're not going to be able to complete these, so he doesn't want to repay the debt.
No,
because he's a dick.
Fucking what's his name? That wants to be repaid.
Right.
He just passed Roach.
I know.
Yeah.
Roach can't.
The guy that wants to be repaid was the one like standing right there.
Yeah.
And we were like, well, where do we find it?
Maybe he didn't know.
And he's like, go find Shawnee, she'll know.
Uh huh.
As if he doesn't already know that we're at the fucking manor.
But we needed the sensor chick anyway. So, like, we needed her anyway, right?
We just needed the sensor, I guess. But
so, like, we needed more pieces than just, yeah, where is it?
But we still have the Xenovox.
It's true.
I mean, that doesn't do anything for us, and we still have the lantern.
I don't think that does anything either.
That talks to ghosts.
Some ghosts.
I'm gonna laugh if we have to use the lantern to find him.
Yeah. Don't worry about it. Herbalist hut.
Herbalist hut? You don't say.
Well, have row, please.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna go ahead and just keep on going here.
Not what I thought was gonna happen.
Yeah, let's yeah. I was
so
okay, yeah.
The girl, Hannah, her parent, everything like that, so they have their lawsuit.
Against
the school. To say there was bullying going on, they just let it happen.
Uh-huh.
Now, another thing that apparently all high schools have that I was unaware of is graffiti in every bathroom stall saying so-and-so is a slut, fuck this guy, you know, things like that.
Yeah, that's like one of the bathrooms might have that.
Yeah, no, this is like every bathroom they show.
And it's like just someone like scraped it into the side of
the
thing.
Yeah, but this one has like multiple markers. People are like talking on it, you know.
Yeah, no, it's not very common.
Yeah, and it's not just like in one stall. It's in every stall, like up the walls.
It's like that's how the boys of this high school communicate.
This is in the boys' bathroom and the girls' bathroom.
And in high school, people are. It's not as common in high school. Like that's like, something you see in like junior high, maybe even fucking elementary, you might see some shit.
People think that shit's cool.
Yeah, but like high school, like the kids aren't in that direction
anymore. And you see why I'm like, this doesn't make sense.
Nothing adds up here.
Yeah, like all these things are not making for a realistic feeling to this.
Right.
And like everyone that's been watching it that I've seen on my Facebook feeds, like, you have to watch this show. It's so real and close to heart. And I'm like, all right, look, I wanted to kill myself for a long time.
Yeah, I went to an insane asylum.
I've had this issue.
I've actually had this problem. Like, this isn't something I fucking dreamed of in a fucking fever dream of like, oh, I'm so unnoticed and shit. Like,
yeah.
You're a little closer to the whole
like,
story than
yeah, and like
a lot of other people that weren't just you weren't just like the emo kid where you had like black hair or some shit.
Yeah.
Like, trying to be fashionable or something.
Like, I wasn't just, like, that guy.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Fuck off.
This is some fucking Dark Souls shit here.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, like, this whole thing where people are like, oh, this is so close to home. And I'm like,
how? Where? What specifically is
and
anywhere like, close to any reality?
Only that, the whole entire other issue that I'm not going to actually talk about on this episode, show, whatever you want to call this whole thing, that we've talked about with our... that involves people that we both know.
Yep.
Their whole situation with this.
Uh-huh.
Like, it's not only just like, I know, like, what her end is like, quote unquote.
Yeah.
But I've also seen other people that have gone through what happened.
Right.
And none of this is adding up.
Right. Like, at all.
Like, zero.
This is like, it kind of sounds like, in a weird way, like glorifying it.
Yes.
And some kind of like, you know?
Yeah. And like.
It's always open to you.
Oh. Well, hello.
Master Tropical.
He's
Oh, he's the better herbalist.
Yeah, hey. That's not racist at all.
No.
That other guy was, fine. There's nothing wrong with him.
The other guy wasn't as good because he wasn't as tall.
Right. Right. That makes sense. We'll go with that.
And so, like, the whole situation and like what people are saying about it just feels off in the first place.
Right. Well, it sounds like what a kid who's like 14 and like is like going through puberty would write in like their fucking journal.
It's
as like their imaginary scenario of this is how I would want to go, but like they've never done anything.
Yeah.
And like they wouldn't do it and they're not going to do it. Like that's what this sounds like to me.
This
like
sounds
some kid fucking wrote this out.
This sounds like our boy Illidan's story right here. Like,
does it?
When you're like 14, you hear Illidan's story. Like, he's not power hungry. He's trying to help his brother, and he's always just cut down by the man kind of thing. You know, it's like everything's just against him from the beginning. And when you're 14, you're just like, oh man, it's all angsty and like. Mm.
Yeah, that's what it sounds like to
me. That's what. Yeah, and so that's another reason why I'm just kind of like. No.
What are your friends on the Facebook page? Are they all fucking 14 still?
No, it's just like, most of them are like lefty liberals, you know. That,
right.
And like, not that there's anything wrong with that. Nah. Mm. Like, I'm not fucking political in any way, shape, or form.
Right. But that's just kind of what they're...
But like, the whole social justice warrior system.
Oh, look at her.
The SJWs, you could say.
Yeah.
Aww, she made a wreath.
I've never seen this side of you.
What side is that?
How do I put this? Your romantic side? Used to seeing you surrounded by bandages and medicine vials, often covered in blood.
Well, that's because you usually come round while I'm at work. Off duty now. Waiting for you, weaving a garland for the wedding.
She's getting married, okay.
Didn't know you were getting married.
Not mine.
Okay, we're fine.
My friend. This garland's not for me.
Hey, those are spectacles.
Which? Yeah. Would you go with me?
We can go to a wedding with her. Whatever gets us closest to banging, we do. We are not a one-woman man.
We are not a one-woman man.
We've been doing this from the beginning. We're not a one-woman man.
I would be glad to accompany you to the wedding.
I'm not glad. I'm going because of a reason, but.
Oh, I'm glad.
Sure.
Not about the wedding.
Oh, thank God.
So, it's a date.
She said the D word.
Censor.
Oh my God. This feels so wrong.
Nearly caught me slipping it into my satchel.
No, it sounds so wrong. Sure it feels so right.
So I also took a mix of amber. Aniseed and juniper, too. All rather smoky when lit.
Thanks. I've become very attached to Yennefer and our little daughter.
As am I.
Shall we?
But this is another universe.
Let's go.
It's going to take me a while to detach myself from that.
It's all right. I can detach myself from practically anything.
You're pretty good at that.
Impressive.
Whoa.
Yeah. Too bad it's falling apart.
But... The family hit on hard times. No coin to splurge on such luxuries.
Whoa.
Ooh. That looks just a little too creepy for me.
It's a little too creepy don't for have you, to Mason. Come if you
don't no, because we're talking about 13 Reasons Why and 13 Reasons Why I hate
like
it.
That idea.
See that shit? If look what I did. Fuck your show. I'm sorry, Selena Gomez. You're still an angel in my book, but how could you produce such a show?
Was she the producer for
she's
that?
She's an executive producer of the show.
That actually makes an unbelievable amount of sense.
I know, and that's why I'm like, ah!
Like a million percent sense of why it would... Oh my God. In like one fucking sentence, you've explained everything of everything.
Yeah, of why the show is the way it is.
Wow.
I know.
Wow. Can't believe it.
And it was upon finding this out where we finally decided, okay,
my head just exploded.
So
wow.
We're gonna talk about heads exploding later. I have more to talk about, dude. I brought a lot.
Holy shit.
Alright.
We're not gonna have time for all that.
I don't know if we will. Depends on what we're recording today. I brought enough for a full day.
Well, I mean, I guess we could talk about it on Gwent, or if you want to just keep doing Witcher 3, or...
Well, I mean, we have a lot of Gwent left over. I just don't know if you're going to end up posting that, because it's all pre-patch.
That's another issue I had with it. And also, I needed to make thumbnails, and I just didn't get around to it. But it was pre-patch, so I was like, man, do I want to upload these? I have two of them uploaded, but they've been sitting there for, like, a week.
Uh-huh.
It was Spellcheska and Filthguard Part 1.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure if I want to upload those.
I don't know either, but speaking of Filthguard, I think I have the deck down.
Mm, like the revisions we need?
I think so.
I just kind of want them to be on the new patch now, so you know what I mean?
This wouldn't be easy.
Which I'm like, that's fine. We can always redo the Spellcheska one. Because like that one was just between Spellcheska and the other guy.
Yeah. And the other guy one sucked, so I wasn't even going to upload that one. So I put a little thing at the end of Spellcheska. So I might still do Spellcheska, but maybe we'll skip Filthguard and the other ones.
Yeah.
and just redo them.
But yeah, I did some work with it, and with the new card.
Well, I guess there was a lot of like, because we played it pre like that patch. So there's probably a lot of buffs and changes to things.
That's what I'm saying. Is the new cards make a huge difference? And there's some other stuff I didn't. Oh my god, that was cool.
I mean, there you go. That's that happened.
Anyway. So in the show, all that shit's going on, you know.
Yep.
She's got the picture taken from the first time, the second picture, the stalker. Everyone's mad at the clay dude because he keeps doing things that none of them is, like, they just listened to him and passed him on.
Yeah.
And then kind of created like a group. But then we get to the part where we were finally like, okay, Hannah's a fucking bitch.
Yeah.
So there's one guy who, this guy, he honestly, like, it seems the whole show, like, the whole time, like, this tape goes on, that he's trying to, like, talk to her and be like, look, like, I'm sorry this is happening to you. I'll try my best to, like, make sure things get taken care of. And she's just constantly mad at him because he's one of the jocks.
Yeah.
But he also, like, hates all his friends.
Mm-hmm.
But they are the only people he kind of has.
Surprises. Yeah, to, like, hang out sure with.
And so. She, like, talks about it. She's like, you're the most loved person who is also the most lonely person.
Yeah.
You'll know what I'm talking about. And, like,
Alexei, age 19, beloved son and brother.
The whole show, or the whole episode, she's, like, talking about, like, what's happened. Then there's
fire, in honor of the dead. Custom.
Like, in this communications class is what it's called.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's him, your little friend. Voldir or whatever. Mm.
Probably shouldn't touch that.
Probably shouldn't.
Vladimir von Everick.
How'd I know? Could have been the sword in the front?
No. That doesn't make sense.
Gotta spread the incense throughout the crypt, every room.
Okay, well, good thing I'm talking about shit.
Yeah, go for it.
They have these, like, bags, like, compliment bags.
Okay.
Or, like, communications. I have no idea. You leave a note. You leave notes in there.
Okay.
Okay, I don't understand.
Okay.
And the main character, like, draws doodles, and so, like, he's leaving notes in her bag, and she thinks that they are from this Asian guy who's the guy who's, like, nice to her the whole time.
How do we spread the incense here?
You have to equip it with, or use the sensor like you would the
let's go this way.
Yeah, let's go in there first. Fuck it.
Yeah, I see what you're saying. Oh, yeah, I see what you're saying.
Yeah.
Probably, maybe.
Let's see, what's this? Crypt key. We needed that for some reason. Don't know why yet. But yeah, the Asian guy, I don't remember his name in the show.
Mm-hmm.
He's the one that's like...
Call him Hattori.
Hattori?
Yeah.
That's actually one of my brother's friends' last names.
Nice.
And they call him Hattori-kun.
Eh? Hattori-kun?
Yeah.
Daisuki desu yo.
Hey, he's... I'm subscribed to him on my channel. You guys go check him out if you want. His videos are shitty.
Well... there you go. There's your shout-out, buddy.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Chris... There's your shout out. Check this one out. Because you'll somehow see this episode. You don't watch this shit. I know you don't. You say you do. I check your fucking...
I watch your history, bitch.
Not your history. I ask him questions about what we did last week.
Oh, and he just can't answer it.
No, because they're like, yeah, we watched this video. I'm like, oh, did you now? What happened?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. And I just laugh.
Yeah.
Anyway.
So a compliment bag.
So the compliment bag is like, so she thinks that the Asian guy's leaving her the compliments.
Oh, okay.
Which aren't really compliments, it's more,
These guys are really loud.
Yeah, kind of loud situation. Just stand there for a sec, don't worry, they won't hit you. And so, like, you leave little notes, and she thinks it's him leaving these little doodle notes. They're like, what's up, Hannah?
Yeah.
But it's really the main character, Clay Dude. And so, finally, she writes a note to him, or she writes a note and puts it in her own bag with tape because she thinks she's also stealing her comments, like her compliments.
Mm-hmm.
I don't understand the whole, like, I didn't quite follow what was going on completely. That's a lot of lager lubes.
I was picking up, so I just kept hitting E.
So she thinks he's stealing her compliments because the rabbits disappear,
right?
But it's just because he stops writing them.
Right.
Or the main character does. And then she leaves this note in there, and for whatever reason, he reaches into her bag to like leave a note, but he takes some anyway. I don't understand really what happens with it. Like, it didn't make any sense with what was going on.
Mm-hmm.
And so he takes this note, and she thinks that he shows it to all these people because it's like all these things that are like, hey, this is what's going on in my life right now. And she sees him just throw a piece of paper on the floor, and she thinks it's the note.
Yeah.
Or she says it's the note, and constantly, like, the people that have gotten the tape say that she's lying about everything. But then he says he still has the note. So it's this whole weird thing, but, like, the entire time, he's done nothing wrong, really. Like, and she just, like, sits there, and she's like, you're in the tapes because of this. I'm assuming you just have to walk around a certain amount. Just spread the incense.
Life and death, fire and blood.
Hero priest. Is it working? Hero priest. If I click any buttons, he doesn't.
Yeah, maybe that's all we have to do.
Hero.
We spread the incense.
Usually, the circle goes away when you do that.
Do you need to hop up that ledge?
Probably not. This is like in the cave.
Well, I mean, it's just in the circle, so.
Do, do, do.
Maybe you just have to say the things in every room.
Yeah.
But I agree with you. The circle usually does disappear.
That's okay. We'll just walk to the next one. Let's put this away.
Nope. So. Yeah, that happens in that episode.
Arise as a friend, for I am no foe.
And
arise from the dust, ye whose blood I have.
Hey, brought. That circle went away.
Hey, see, it's working.
What the hell?
Return and walk midst the living, ye who hath departed.
Yeah.
Maybe we had to do it in some order.
Arise from the dust, ye whose blood I have brought.
So now we like walk to the last one.
I guess so.
Return and walk midst the living. Ye who hath departed.
Ooh. Skin spooky, scary skeleton. We're about to have a party.
Arise as a friend, for I am no foe.
Oh, this is a different area.
Life and death, fire and blood.
Time to light the votive fire.
Yes, so we were supposed to do it in order.
I see.
But
whatever works.
Yeah.
Dude, let's light this
shit. That's a lot more incense.
Yeah. Ooh, spooky, scary.
Fire and blood, life and death, I summon ye whose blood I have brought.
We just drink it? Okay.
Ugh.
That's
fire. That's
disgusting.
And blood,
mm-hmm.
Life and death.
You have summoned me, stranger. Why?
Name's Geralt. Came to wake the ghost of Vladimir von Everek.
Who you are, and why you've come matter little. For you'll not leave this place alive.
Are you Vlad's ghost?
Who asks after my grandson?
It matters not, Honoratina.
Honoratina?
How this mortal obtained the family's blood. For von Everick's rise only for von Everick blood.
True. Yeah,
cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yet to my knowledge, only one of our line yet lives. Olgird. Then we converse with the man who spilled the blood of your grandson, Kestetis.
Mean none of you are Vladimir? It's Olgird, his brother, who sent me.
You will meet Vlad soon enough. Yet Olgird, you will never see
so
again.
So we have to kill them.
Oh. Alright, well. Looks like we're gonna have some time.
Yurden.
For Olgird's blood.
Easy enough.
Uh-huh.
Technique is fire hurts ghosts.
Yep. The one weakness of a ghost. Fire. If I've learned anything.
Oh my god. But yeah,
Oh.
So then they go to, like, this is near the end of it. This is like near the very like final parts of the show at this point.
Okay.
Because I either stopped paying attention enough that I don't remember what happened after the guy, but I don't think anything really important does. Like,
I don't think anything important has happened.
Well, nothing important happened. Oh, hey, look at that. We're already in another cutscene. Well, you looky there. Lord, where are you?
My, my. Ornery horse sons those Von Emmerichs, eh?
Who are you?
That was cool.
The rogue you seek. Vladimir Von Emmerich, brother to Olgierd.
Oh.
Oh, forgot I cannot even scratch my stones. Though in point of fact, they've not itched much since I died.
Didn't want to fight your family. They started it.
I'm dead, not blind. I preferred to see how you'd handle those snobby pricks. And Grandmum, too. Besides, what harm could you do them? They're dead as it is.
It's true.
That's, you're not wrong.
Kind of like this guy.
Now tell me how you came into Olgierd's blood. If you hurt him, I fear I shall have to kill you.
Good luck.
I got it from a mutual acquaintance of mine and Olgierd's. I'm here on important business.
I'm a swithing corpse, with no interest in important matters, yours or any other buckers. The sole thing I miss is feasting, corporal diversion, so to speak. But alas.
Now, if you all remember, that's the same haircut Olgierd's friends have.
Mm-hmm. Maybe they forced it to him to be like his brother?
That's what I'm saying, because he said those Von Emmerichs.
Visitors.
Right.
That's what, I mean, you know, often, I just like looking for conspiracies.
When someone does drop by, the whole band comes out to play.
Fun-loving family.
True. We're famed for our love of revelry and rumbles. We Von Emmerichs have brawled and raided for generations. It's tradition. Naturally, with raids comes loot. So we always had the means to celebrate right lavishly. Towards the end of my life was when things went sour. But no point poking at old wounds. Just days before I died, my brother claimed he'd found a way to dig us out, restore our state.
Well, he sent us.
Mm-hmm.
Your brother sent me.
How is the old rogue? What I wouldn't give to ride by his side again.
No chance of that happening. Could experience something else, though. Something a corpse should find interesting.
Interesting? Out with it. What do you have in mind?
I'm supposed to show you the time of your life.
Yeah. Who cares how we died?
Olgierd gave me a job. Odd as it may sound, I need to show you the time of your life.
But you're dead.
Is that so? Now that, sir, is a brother. I've been dead for years, yet he still looks after me, after my spirits. How much time do we have?
Think one night should do the trick?
Splendid. Wait just a moment while I hoist my saber and...
Oh yeah, I can't grab it.
What the blistering devils?
You're a ghost. Can't grab things.
I keep forgetting.
Not the other ghosts that were attacking
me. How am I to revel and rock and fuck? Can't lift a tankard to my lips. Can't wield a saber. Can't squeeze a wench as we dance a jig.
You're not
Guess
wrong.
Have to do without. Let's go.
How did they hold swords?
Yeah.
I will go nowhere. You're to see I enjoy myself, correct? Well, then think of a way to make it possible.
Let's possess us.
Revive my flesh.
No can do. Besides, body's probably decomposed.
Then bloody come up with another way. I'll not go anywhere.
I'm gonna let him possess
state.
Us and go on a night of debauchery. Stuff.
Are we gonna put him in the body of the guy down in the well, or in where we got the key?
And you.
I don't know.
You could borrow their body just for the night.
You wish me to possess someone?
Yeah.
Say I agree. Whose body would I inhabit?
Dunno. One of Olgierd's men, maybe? Or a peasant who'd agree to do it for coin?
Oh, no, no, no. I shan't crawl into the skin of some unwashed bandit or dung-eating swineherd. I've a better idea.
Oh, no. Not gonna happen.
Oh, well, too late. You're right, Joel.
Oh, yes. Yes, it is.
And we're off.
Geralt, I wonder.
Wake up.
Oh no.
Rise.
Oh no.
No.
The shenanigans. What are we in, an anime? Oh god damn it.
Death was a small price to pay to lie in a lap so lovely.
Oh god damn it.
And so near the wonders concealed.
Oh god damn it.
Oh Jesus.
Not this.
Yes, as soon as I laid eyes on you, promise to stay and stroke my chin, and I shall spend the rest of eternity in a hound's body, trotting along by your well-turned calves.
Geralt? What's happened to you?
At least she knows.
Geralt? I'm Vladimir.
What?
Blast. Fine, fine, give me a moment.
Oh.
Yeah. Definitely don't like being possessed.
You'd not have fainted had you not resisted so fiercely.
Passed out.
Care to explain what's going on here?
Sorry about that.
Yeah, sorry.
Sorry about that, Shani. That wasn't me.
So who was it?
Me.
Shut up.
I didn't say anything.
Oh,
she can't see him.
I wasn't talking to you.
Who to then?
Well, to him. To Vladimir.
Geralt, there's no one else here.
Seems your lovely maiden friend can neither see nor hear me. There's potential in that.
Leave her out of this.
Leave Shani out of this.
Ah, is that a name? Lovely. A perfect name for a perfect lass.
You're testing my patience.
As you are mine. Can you please explain what's going on here?
Ooh, fiery. Temperament matches the drink.
Listen, I'm supposed to show Vladimir von Everreck the time of his life. Turned out, he's a ghost. So, willing or not, I gotta lend him my body.
Wait a minute. Are you saying you're possessed?
Not at the moment. Just now he's standing next to me, coyly grinning at you. But off and on, he'll enter my body. So anything I say or do will actually be him, his mind, his intent.
What if I want to talk to you, not him?
Well, she should approach me and ask me to jump out for a bit.
Just come up and ask him to leave for a while.
I see.
Splendid!
Right then, Sugar Plum. Let's say you leave this dank crypt.
Yay.
There's a charming grove nearby where kisses taste sweeter than anywhere else in the world.
I take it you're Vladimir now. Doesn't seem like I'll have trouble telling you apart from Geralt.
Oh, we get to pick for him.
Yes, it's beautiful. I love it.
No.
It has become great. Geralt's a bore.
My sentiments exactly. Between you and me. This Witcher fellow is an awful bore.
Only sometimes.
Seems we're kindred spirits. So, off to the nearest hedgerow.
I'm afraid I have to turn you down, dear ghost.
A shame. In that case, point me to the nearest brothel.
I've got a better idea.
Ooh. Okay.
Just before Geralt entered the crypt to summon you, I invited him to my friend's wedding.
Oh. Good heavens. That's damn good luck. No better dancer in all Redania than Vladimir von Everreck. My future mother. Maybe you shall enjoy an evening to top all others.
Wonderful. I must stop by my home first and change. So, we'll meet at the temple.
Well, it looks like we don't get to fuck.
I don't like the sound of that.
Why not?
I'm not fond of temples, see? When alive, I'd only set foot in one to loot it. And in death, I find I despise them all the more. Could we not meet after the ceremony, go straight to the feast?
All right. Seems we've no other option.
Splendid. Then I shall see you at the wedding manor.
Oh my god. This is great. I love it. I'm glad we got to explain ourselves.
Yep.
That's what I was worried about.
A man could lose his head for a lass like that. And that comes from none other than Vladimir von Everick, famed for his taste in women.
And his very well taken care of horse.
Are you her paramour?
What?
For if so, you have my word, I shall keep my distance. But if not, then... the haylofts we shall devastate together.
Well, is she ours? In our opposite world?
I guess so. I don't even fucking know her, but I don't think... But, Mason.
If he bangs her, we indirectly bang her. It's like the indirect kiss in all animes.
Yes, sir.
But do we want it to be him or us?
I mean, how weirdly meta are we getting right now? Because none of it's us.
I know. I don't think it matters what we say, but...
I cared for her.
As far as we know, we don't know who this person is.
Yeah, we cared for her.
Let's say we were more than friends once upon a time.
You tried to hide it, but I smelled a tryst. I know a thing or two about
I really like to look at the ghosts. Or this ghost.
A shame, though. I'd have satisfied her well. But no cavalier would rot in another's garden. So, Witcher, time for the wedding?
Let's
I think
go.
We made the wrong choice.
Onward. I'll be right behind you.
God damn it.
They're in sync.
I love it. This quest is so cool.
This is a good quest.
So I'm guessing this is the way out.
A comely maid. You're quite the fool if you've not plowed her yet.
Keep your paws off her.
I'm to enjoy myself. Can I help it that I best like tumbles in the hay with fleshy lasses?
Yeah.
You and I both, friend.
This whole witcher's life, what's it like?
That's cool.
Don't want to know.
That's pretty cool.
If indeed I didn't, I'd not have asked. Go on, tell me.
You wouldn't like it.
Let's keep going.
Cool. So, this is around, since we stopped watching right here, we looked up the rest.
Those
oh,
signs.
Fuck you.
I'd like to try.
Fine, I'll wait till next episode.
I don't think you're gonna get to finish this time.
Never done it. Could be interesting.
Rather not waste any time.
Till the stroke of midnight, what I would rather is what matters.
It's true. He's not wrong.
He's not.
Dun, 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 dun.
It looks like we're holding a sword. It
does look like I'm holding a sword. Probably not supposed to look like that.
I think the game thinks we are.
There we go.
There we go, you fixed it.
Yay! Von Everick Estate.
I think this would be like the worst game to try and speedrun.
You think so?
At like...
Maybe that's my thing. I could speedrun The Witcher 3.
I remember that mill.
You could.
Olgierd and I got up to mischief,
we already have a good time to beat.
Our PV is pretty bad, so I think we can beat our PV pretty good here.
Those were the days.
By like a lot.
Yeah.
By like.
No, I was gonna say.
By like 40 hours, we could beat our PV. I feel like.
I was gonna say on a. 100% run.
Right.
This would be like the worst game ever.
Oh yeah, it would be. How would you even quantify that?
100% would be completing all quests.
100% means different things for different.
Yeah.
Things though.
I think 100% just means 100% completion, but you can have different categories. These are cool mechers.
Yes, they are.
They're probably gonna fuck our world. But if you just did like. Any percent, all quests or something like that.
Uh-huh. Would it include like side quests and things though, or is it just main quests?
I would think side quests.
See, that's the thing. Any percent means many different things.
Yeah, I know, that's what I'm saying. Like, you'd have to like make a very special thing. Like, if it was like any percent, that would just be finishing.
I'm sure there's people that do speedrun this.
Oh, I'm sure there is. I'm sure speed it's run fucking god awful.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know, there might be cheatsy doodles to like speed things up in certain ways.
Yeah.
You know.
I don't disagree. I completely agree. Like, there's things you could do in this, I'm sure.
What's this?
A crick. A farm.
Oh, well, I guess there's... We're, like, way off to the side. I guess we can do some of this bullshit.
We could.
So you got time to talk about your thing.
Okay, so...
Let's finish it up before...
Yeah, I can finish it. I can finish it. So, the way that... There, after that, the guy listens to his tape, and it turns out there was this party they all went to, and constantly, like, there's, like, flashbacks of, like, him, like, making out with her, and it looks like they're gonna fuck. But so, Hannah and Clay end up in someone's bedroom at some point at this party, and they go to start, like, making out, but then she just, like, screams at him to stop. And then she hides, and then she hears someone coming in, so she hides in the closet. And a guy comes in, and,
Knickers surface here. Dig their
it's
way out.
Her best friend and her new boyfriend.
Yeah.
And something happens, the boyfriend starts to leave, because she's too drunk. Did we, like, clear a settlement? Oh my god, they had no arms!
Well, that was terrifying.
So, they, he leaves the room, and the Bryce guy comes in and rapes, the best friend girl.
Yeah.
But she's too drunk to know what happened.
Mm-hmm.
And so she forgets about it and doesn't even know. And, but... Hannah was hiding in the room and she knows.
Right. So she saw.
Yeah.
And she obviously doesn't tell anybody.
Yeah, she says nothing. Doesn't even tell the girl.
Yep. Which might be not a bad idea. Right?
Yeah.
If the other chick doesn't know nothing and...
Yeah, but then her boyfriend also knew what was going to happen because his friend like walked past and he's like, hey, what's yours is mine, right?
Okay. That doesn't make sense, but okay.
Yeah, it doesn't. Like, the whole situation...
That'd be like me showing up and, like... why... yours is mine, Mason. Like, why would you say that?
We need to wait.
Uh-oh. Here we go.
Well, I could have finished had this not happened.
You were so close.
I know. I come so far.
This is very romantic.
I tried so hard and come so far. In the end, it doesn't matter. Fuck off. God, this quest is great.
So good.
Behold, wars have started over uglier wenches. Well, raids have been undertaken at least.
True, she looks lovely. Let's go.
She looks like she did like 5 minutes ago.
Whoa,
red dress.
Hold.
She's got the stockings on.
Need to go in wearing that.
What else?
Have you seen how she's dressed? I'll not parade at that jewel's side in a rank tunic. You need a robe. One daren't attend a wedding in anything less.
Don't happen to have a robe handy.
What do you mean? What about that?
Okay. Good idea.
Good idea.
All in all, why not?
Ah, that's the spirit.
We gotta give him the time of his life.
Mm-hmm. At least he's gonna steal it for us.
Yeah.
This'll do wonderfully.
I like the blue color for his text, too.
Yes, I like that it distinctly makes sure we know.
And it's a very good blue color.
Yeah. It's Halo Bravo blue.
Yes,
perfect
it is.
Fit. It feels tailor-made.
Hell yeah.
Now, for shoes. One must wear shoes to a wedding.
I think that's just our chest piece and, like, our armor is still the same, like, our pants are.
Yeah. No! And we must be neat.
Oh, my God.
Immediately hate the quest.
This piece of shit. didn't even give us a choice, which makes sense.
And he has the best haircut. I'm happy now.
May they draw and quarter me if I've ever seen a lovelier lass.
Nothing left of you to draw and quarter, alas.
Doe eyes, a swan's soft, supple neck, and a waist so slim you could grip it one-handed.
That... You're actually quite amusing this way.
Aww. She's adorable.
We must get to know each other better.
You see, Geralt can't hold a candle to me. We gotta keep mentioning Geralt so she doesn't forget us.
Right, you're right, you're right. You're all right.
See? Geralt's been a pill, a nag. That all changes today.
Dramatically, I'd say. He's never been very talkative to start with.
He's been a fool. But I shall make up for that now. Will you marry me?
A big step, but I will think about it. For now, we should simply enjoy my friend's wedding. May I please speak to Geralt for a moment?
Whatever for. This evening is about my pleasure, not his.
Just for a moment, then you can jump right back in.
Be quick. I'll not stand here doing naught. I'm to enjoy myself.
Geralt, I'm about to introduce you to the newlyweds. Please make sure your friend doesn't embarrass me.
You know what that means?
I can't make him do anything. All that nonsense is his. I feel like an ass saying it.
I liked some of that nonsense.
Oh. Not for example. I'm not. You're I not. Will not ask that question, Mason. You can go
agree.
Fuck
I agree.
Yourself.
Hey, I'm right there with you, man.
I will not ask. I can't handle it. Okay.
It's not Johnny we're talking to.
Jesus Christ. The Johnny question was bad. This is where I'm drawing the goddamn line, okay? We are not asking for example, okay? Not doing it.
I'm glad if you accidentally clicked it.
Yeah, I would have too. Would have walked out. Kicked my green screen over. Fucking walked out.
Kicked it over. Shit lately.
Dance till the break of dawn.
You get till midnight and not a second longer.
That's not enough. I shan't even get properly soused by midnight, let alone...
Make an effort. I'm sure you'll manage. You get to frolic and carouse till midnight. That's our deal. Then there's the capping. Then you go back where you came from.
So be it.
He always gets a smirk every time he goes in.
Nice strawberry. I get it, because she's got red hair and a dress that's red.
She's so cute.
Kawaii.
I like her more than I like Triss.
Yeah, me too. Overall so far. Yeah. Mainly because of the voice actress.
I mean, that doesn't...
I'll be damned.
That doesn't hurt the situation.
Overladen tables, plenty of worthy drinking companions, and a swarm of fair maids.
Yeah, boy.
But you have Swanee.
Swanee?
I need to try and make a Kyra out of this one yet.
Jesus. Shani.
Shwani.
Seamus. Beware of the dog, Shani. Judging by the size of its house, the mutt must be big as a horse.
Thanks for your concern, but the doghouse is empty.
They let a man-eater like that run free? Have the wedding guests been warned? Seems we are indeed in for a cracking good time.
He talks fantastically. Like, yeah. This dialogue is...
Well done, game designers. / writer.
What a lovely rowan. I remember making necklaces of the fruit when I was a child.
Ah, the berries make for splendid hooch. Olgird and I brew it in our teething years.
I shall introduce you to the newlyweds now. Try to behave.
So,
my rowan petal, I'd do anything.
This seems like we're gonna have to answer some questions here. Excuse me, but we are at 58 minutes.
We will answer them next time.
Yes, we will. Next time on The Witcher.
We're gonna... Oh, this is really fun. I really like this.
This is a great quest.
We will see you guys next time. Jamata.
Bye. Swanee.